Did you know that skipping the autotune process on a VFD before commissioning a motor can cause overheating, torque instability, and even premature failure? Yes, that's right. Many engineers make the mistake of assuming the motor will just work, but without proper autotuning, your system might be running at only 60-70% efficiency. So what exactly does a VFD do during autotuning, and why is it so important? Stick with me. And by the end of this video, you'll know exactly why auto-tuning is a game-changer for motor performance. A variable frequency drive, or VFD, controls the speed of an AC motor by adjusting voltage and frequency. But here's the problem. Each motor has different electrical characteristics. If the VFD doesn't know these characteristics, it applies generic settings, leading to energy losses, poor speed control, and unnecessary wear and tear. That's where auto-tuning comes in. The VFD runs a series of tests to learn about the motor's resistance, inductance, and dynamic response, and draws a mathematical model, stores it in memory, and prepares a control algorithm. This allows it to optimize power delivery, improve efficiency, and ensure smooth operation. Now, not all auto-tuning is the same. Most VFDs offer two main types of auto-tune processes: static, stationary, autotune, and dynamic, rotational, autotune. Static autotune, stationary test, measures electrical parameters without rotating the motor. Useful when the motor is connected to a load that cannot be decoupled, e.g., a pump or gearbox. Less accurate, but still improves efficiency compared to no tuning at all. Dynamic autotune, rotational test, requires the motor to rotate freely during the test. Provides high precision data by measuring real-time response under voltage and frequency variations. Highly recommended for vector control applications where torque and speed accuracy are critical. So, which one should you choose? If your motor can be disconnected from the load, always go for dynamic autotune for the best results. Now let's get into the details. When you start auto-tuning, the VFD systematically measures and calculates several motor parameters. Here's what happens under the hood, static or stationary auto-tune process. It is used when the motor cannot rotate as it may be connected to a load. A small DC voltage is applied to the stator windings, and the resulting current is measured. Ohm's law, VIR, is used to calculate stator resistance. Then the VFD injects DC pulse signals and measures the motor's leakage Ls and magnetizing inductance linear. These two, stator resistance and inductance, help determine how the motor windings react to AC voltage. Rotor resistance, RRR. Estimation. Since the rotor isn't moving, the VFD estimates this value based on other measurements, but it is important for vector control and slip compensation. Result. The VFD updates its motor model, but does not fully optimize dynamic performance. Dynamic, rotational, autotune process. It is used when the motor can rotate freely. Motor is uncoupled from load for best accuracy. The VFD runs the motor at low speed while collecting real-time data. Initial resistance and inductance checks. The procedure is the same as static autotune. The VFD applies small DC pulses to measure the resistance and inductance of the stator winding. This helps in optimizing voltage and current control. Rotor resistance, RR, and inductance, LR. The rotor's electrical resistance is calculated to improve torque accuracy. The VFD applies a controlled voltage frequency to gradually accelerate the motor to a predefined speed to measure motor response time, current draw, and voltage feedback. These measurements help calculate RR and LR. Inductance measurements help the VFD predict how the motor responds to voltage changes. Magnetizing current, M, determines the optimal current required to generate the magnetic field inside the motor. Slip measurement and compensation. The VFD calculates actual motor slip by comparing rotor speed versus synchronous speed. The VFD calculates the difference between actual speed and synchronous speed, ensuring stable motor operation. Improves speed regulation in variable torquey applications. Back EMF, counter voltage. Analysis, the VFD measures the counter electromotive force, back EMF, generated by the spinning rotor. This is essential for vector control, and its value helps fine-tune field-oriented control, FOC. Helps the VFD apply just the right amount of voltage to prevent overheating. Inertia and load compensation test, optional. Some VFDs measure motor inertia by applying load variations and monitoring the response. Helps optimize acceleration-deceleration times. Bearing and shaft current analysis, advanced VFDs only. Some high-end VFDs also detect bearing currents to prevent premature bearing failure. In short, the VFD builds a complete electrical and mechanical mathematical model of the motor, allowing it to run with maximum efficiency and precision. Let us go through what input data is needed to auto-tune a VFD. You need to navigate to the VFD settings menu and select the auto-tune option. Depending on the VFD, there may be options for static auto-tune, stationary, or dynamic auto-tune, rotational. Input motor nameplate. Data. The user must enter key motor parameters from the motor nameplate, including rated voltage, V, rated current, A, rated power, HP, KW, rated speed, RPM, rated frequency, Hz, power factor, motor type, e.g. squirrel cage, synchronous. This gives the VFD a reference for expected values. Once auto-tune is complete, the measured values are stored in the VFD memory. The motor control algorithm is updated. The VFD adjusts its voltage, current, and frequency outputs for optimized performance. The user may be prompted to restart the VFD or verify settings. So what's the impact of all this? Let's compare a motor running without auto-tune versus one that's been properly tuned. Without auto-tune, higher energy consumption, poor torque control leading to unstable operation, overheating due to improper current settings, higher risk of insulation damage and premature failure. With auto-tune, lower power consumption, smooth acceleration and deceleration, more precise speed and torque control, reduced wear and tear on motor components. That's why skipping auto-tuning is a costly mistake, both in terms of energy bills and long-term maintenance. So, should you always auto-tune your VFD before running a motor? Absolutely. Whether it's a simple fan or a high-performance servo motor, auto-tuning ensures maximum efficiency, smoother operation, and a longer lifespan for your equipment. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more expert insights on industrial automation and motor control. Also, let me know in the comments, have you ever faced problems with a motor running on a VFD without auto-tune? Let's discuss. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.